is TJ from the Nearly Dads, and you're listening to Pop Punk Radio.
What's up, everybody? This is JD from Pop Punk Radio, and today I want to do a little vintage album review, talking about the album Invisible Tonight by the Nearly Dads. This is an album that came out on June 24th of 2014. We originally released this review on June 23rd, so one day before the release. I've always really enjoyed this album, and recently we've been rolling out some new features, trying to do some video album reviews, so I thought, what a good opportunity for us to go back and retouch some of these old albums that we reviewed years ago. Lead singer Teresa Jean and the band were nice enough to make us some radio tags, so we've always been big fans of the Nearly Deads here at Pop Punk Radio. I think TJ is awesome. She's been doing some solo work recently, and I believe she recently opened up a Patreon. I definitely recommend that you check that out. That's patreon.com/join/Teresa Jean. I'll provide a link in the description. So on with the review. I'm just going to read what we wrote years ago. It's fun to read some of my old reviews because this was when Pop Punk Radio was brand new, and you can really see some of the excitement in my writing. A couple years later, I ended up going back to school, and they really did a good job of beating the creativity and beating the life out of me. So I feel like my writing has suffered in some ways in that regard. I mean, for a time period, I'd really stopped writing reviews, so that was a different chapter in my life. But anyways, on with the review. The Nearly Deads are ready to take the world by storm with their debut full-length titled Invisible Tonight, which released on June 24th, 2014. Although this female-fronted band resides in Nashville, Tennessee, the band's roots hail from Tampa, Florida, with a name inspired by the old Florida saying, home of the newlyweds and nearly deads, as Florida has long been hailed as a retirement destination for America's elderly. Despite releasing just their first full length, the band has been around since 2010, with the release of two EPs in 2011 and 2013. A busy band who performed over 500 shows within those 3 years alone. The band's sound has been compared to Kelly Clarkson fronting the Foo Fighters, and fans of Paramore and Tonight Alive will probably really like the Nearly Deads. The album starts off with a piano harmony that quickly explodes into a powerful declaration of "We're over, we're over," a song about leaving behind an unfulfilling relationship in which the status quo is unacceptable and leaves the listener ready to begin a new story. I'm in the mood to go break some hearts, as TJ sings in the album's debut single, I Said. Adventure continues through the album's 11 tracks with a number of twists and turns, including a few Fight Club references in the song Changeover. And the audience has no idea. The album features a solid mix of energetic sing-along, almost anthemic, is that even a word? Almost anthemic songs about relationships, heartache, and standing strong on your own. As TJ sings in the album's final slow dance titled Never Look Back, Reanimated, who are you judging anyway? It's my neck on the line. Invisible Tonight clocks in at about 35 minutes, which feels like an appropriate length, long enough to feel like a complete musical journey, but short enough to leave the listener wanting more. We give Invisible Tonight by the Nearly Deads a 9 out of 10. An enjoyable listen from start to finish, with catchy choruses that will stick in your head for days after listening. Check out their Wayne's World inspired video for I Said, and make sure you follow Teresa Jean on Patreon because she's doing some great things over there that you don't want to miss. Thank you for checking out our video album review of Invisible Tonight by the Nearly Deads. This is JD from Pop Punk Radio. Thank you for listening.